is God. Like if you're walking down the street and you bounce your foot on a big city ball, oh God, then after you realize who is God. Mark and the word of God make it clear. Too late, shall be the cry. But yet still, you keep on rebelling and rejecting the voice of the Holy Spirit of God. You rather listen to your next door neighbor because why? You love the gossiping. You rather listen to your boss man. You rather listen to your co-worker. You rather listen to your mother or your father. I never said do not listen to them, but I want you to understand the illustration. You rather listen to your husband. You rather listen to your friend, but you do not want to listen. You do not want to listen to the voice of the Holy Spirit. What being? He said, let it be, and it was. You didn't want to listen to him, because why? You choose to listen to your friends. Mankind, listen to me. Sad will be your portion. And the hellfire will furnace. Harden not your heart. Give your heart to God. Give your heart to Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God, before it's too late, because too late, mankind shall be the cry. As the Holy Spirit of God, give me utterance. He said, some of you will make it to the heaven gates. But that is how far you will reach. That is how far you will go. You will be knocking. Lord, let me in. Lord, I do this. I do that for you, Lord. I pray. Lord. Mankind, some of you naturally calling his name. Lord. And he will tell you plainly, I never knew you. Away from me, you workers of iniquity, and he will cast you down the same way he cast the devil down. Listen to me, mankind. You might be saying, the Bible is also authority. Let me tell you something. The very Bible gives an illustration within the context of stories. It's for you to understand the truth. And nothing else but the truth, which is the context of the word of God, because the word of God proceeded out of the mouth of God and manifests unto man, so mankind could teach and to preach the word of God. For you who are lost, waiting to be found. That's why he said, I come for the lost sheep. I mean it. I come for the lost sheep of the world. When he tell you I come for the lost sheep of Israel, is that one group? No. It's all of humanity he died for. He didn't die for a particular group. This white and this black. No. God created one race. It's the human race.
Amen.
Because if you cut a Chinese, if you cut a white man, if you cut a black man, if you cut a yellow man, you get the same blood. Because you know why? God's blood is red. It has no blood type with God. It is red.
Virgin, Jesus love you.
It's for you to understand, mankind. He came for the whole of humanity. He said, I come for the lost sheep of Israel. for you to understand. If you know that you're lost because of the condition that you're living in, by refusing and rebelling and rejecting this word, it's time for you to repent.
Amen.
Because the kingdom of God, which is the word, is at hand. It's right before you. It's right before you. Because this same word that you rejected now is the same word will come back and judge you in the end of the world.
Amen, brother.
Because you know why? Christ, the Son of the living God, is the word.
Amen.
And the word was with God. He told them plain, the Pharisees and the Sadducees, and they got vexed with him because they didn't understand his illustration. He said, before Abraham, I was. What he's telling them as an illustration. Before I make you within your mother's womb, before I formed the world and the universe, I was always there.